Hello, I'm Janae Holmquist Newbry, your 13th District State Senator. Thank you for watching my video update. We've reached the halfway point of the 60-day session, and we've already hit two significant deadlines, the policy and fiscal cutoff dates. This means that only bills that were approved by their assigned committees will continue to move forward in the legislative process. These deadlines are necessary to keep the legislature on track to complete its business within the allotted 60 days. As the chair of the Senate Commerce and Labor Committee, my focus this year has continued to be on ways to improve our business climate and help our employers maintain and create jobs. Many of my bills are focused on private sector job creation. Some have received hearings and others have already passed off the Senate floor and are awaiting action in the House. I also serve on the Trade and Economic Development Committee, where I work on issues relating to international trade, economic development incentives, technical assistance to businesses, and technology-driven economic development. At this point, we aren't hearing bills in committees anymore. We'll return to committee hearings again after February 18th in order to consider bills approved by the House of Representatives. For now, we are on the floor voting on bills to send to the House for its consideration. One of the first major measures addressed on the floor of the Senate this year was a constitutional amendment to restore your Taxpayer Protection Act, which requires a two-thirds majority vote of the legislature to raise taxes. As you may recall, it was a year ago this month that the Washington Supreme Court struck down the two-thirds majority requirement to pass tax increases and pointed to a constitutional amendment as the voters' only means of maintaining the popular Taxpayer Protection Act. Well, my Republican colleagues and I took up that challenge and brought the constitutional amendment to the Senate floor. A constitutional amendment must be endorsed by two-thirds of the Senate and the House of Representatives before it can be added to the following November's general election ballot. Two-thirds of the 49-member Senate is 33 votes. Unfortunately, I am sad to report that the Senate failed to gain the votes necessary to send a constitutional amendment to the voters to restore your Taxpayer Protection Act. The measure failed on a straight party line vote. I believe those votes would have been there if the Democrat senators who voted against the measure would have simply looked at how their legislative districts supported Initiative 1185 and voted accordingly. Initiative 1185 received a 64% yes vote statewide and received majority support in all 39 counties of our state just less than 2 years ago. Now back at home, more than 70% of those voting in our district said yes to the last time they were asked about requiring a two-thirds majority vote for tax increases. You have spoken loudly and often on this issue, and the House and Senate Republicans are listening. I just wish all legislators would listen to their constituents as well, especially when the people have voted for the Taxpayer Protection Act 5 times in the last 20 years. But don't be discouraged. I represent you, the people of the 13th District, and I will continue to stand by you in support of making this requirement a permanent part of the Constitution. As you may remember, I was one of the sponsors of Initiative 1053, which was the 2010 Citizen Initiative on your Taxpayer Protection Act. I sponsored that ballot measure because requiring two-thirds majority vote to increase taxes would protect you against your government reaching further into your wallets instead of simply prioritizing spending and living within our means. Even though Democrats in the legislature have refused to act, my course of action won't change. I will continue to listen to the will of the people on this issue because voters have demanded it and it is the right thing to do. Well, that's all the time I have for my video update this week. In my next video, I will update you on the status of my bills and where they stand in the legislative process. I'll also discuss a vital tax incentive that has the potential to turn Central Washington into the Silicon Valley of data centers. And we'll check on the progress the legislature is making on our Jobs Now agenda. If you have any questions, concerns, or ideas to share, please get in touch with me by calling my office, stopping by, or sending me an email. I am your voice in the Senate, and in order to represent you fully, I need to hear from you. Keep checking my Senate website for the latest updates and on what's happening in the legislature. I'm Janaea Holmquist Newbry, and until next time, remember, I'm fighting to protect you, your wallet, and your rights.